Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I am Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 15th of December. Four militants loot bank in India's Kashmir, two identified by police. Germany deports Afghan asylum seekers. And Madhesi leaders insist constitution amendment prior polls. And now for all the details. A bank in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province was looted by militants on Thursday. Two militants have been identified by the police and a probe has been launched.
In an incident of robbery, militants looted more than $16,000 from Jammu and Kashmir Bank's Ratnipura branch in Pulwama district. The militants barged into the bank in Jammu and Kashmir province on Thursday.
एक बजे के तकरीबन यहाँ कुछ मिलिटेंट्स घुस आए अंदर तीन आ गए हैं और हैंड्स अप करवाए स्टाफ उसके बाद धक्के कैश को धक्के मार के दिए और उसे बोल दिया कि कैश दे दो काउंटर पर जितना कैश था वो अंदर जो लॉकर में था वो लेके चले गए
This is the third bank robbery by militants since the government's announcement of demonetization of 500 and 1000 rupee notes on 8 November.
Staying on to news from India, US Federal Reserve raised interest rates for the first time in a year, only the second time since the 2008 financial crisis. India's chief economic advisor Arvind Subramanian has said that Indian economy is well cushioned to absorb the impact.
Amid fears of capital outflows from the country after US Federal Reserve raised interest rates. India's chief economic advisor Arvind Subramanian on Thursday said that the country's economy is well cushioned to absorb the impact. The Fed raised interest rates on Wednesday as central bankers across the globe are adopting to the incoming Donald Trump administration's promises of tax cuts, spending and deregulation.
I mean, my own view is that on this, the Indian economy is very well cushioned to, you know, absorb the impact of that. It was anticipated. I think the RBI policy also took account of this in a very sensible way. So I think there may be some short-term things, but I think this is not something we need to worry about excessively at all.
Reserve Bank of India, or the RBI, unexpectedly kept interest rates on hold last week, citing concerns that currency volatility resulting from the Fed's actions could impact India's inflation. India is seen as better equipped than its other emerging market peers to weather the impact of higher US interest rates because of its stronger economic growth and record high foreign exchange reserves of more than $300 billion.
Meanwhile, police in Surat city of India's western Gujarat province arrested a Pakistani national with fake currency worth more than $700 of scrapped 500 bills.
The accused, identified as Burhanuddin Sajjad, a resident of Karachi city of Pakistan, was arrested late on Wednesday. Sajjad had entered India on valid tourist visa via Atari border in Punjab province on December 12. 45-year-old Sajjad, who first claimed to be a Mumbai resident, was apprehended at the Surat railway station.
Ek aadmi shankaspad halat mein checking ke dauran pakda gaya hai. Uski interrogation और उसके पास से जो मुद्दा माल बरामद हुआ उसमें से उसके पास एक पाकिस्तानी पासपोर्ट उसके सिवाय 50,000 के नकदी नोट उसमें सभी नोट 500 के दर की है
अपार्ट फ्रॉम फेक करेंसी नोट्स अ वॉलेट अ पासपोर्ट One mobile phone, three SIM cards and $300 bills were also recovered from him. The accused was handed over to the government railway police for further investigation. Relations between India and Pakistan have been strained for several months after attacks on India's military base, while cross-border shelling has intensified, leading to deaths of civilians and soldiers stationed along the disputed frontier.
Meanwhile, people of Pakistan-administered Kashmir have for years been suffering at the hands of the corrupt system of the administration. Despite promises of development made during the elections, people are left abandoned with broken promises.
Elections in the illegally occupied region of Pakistan-administered Kashmir have largely been a disappointment for the people in the region. A local, Raja Iqbal Minhas, an advocate by profession who supported the PMLN government in the elections, is now rattled with the present ruling establishment. Like Iqbal, there are many others in the region who suffered government apathy even after participating in a so-called democratic process. Promises made before the elections are forgotten, and innocent locals are made to suffer at the hands of corrupt administration.
कहा जाता है इस मुल्क के अंदर मुस्लिम लीग नून की को वक्त कायम करने के लिए बड़ी मेहनत की बहुत जद्दोजहद की लोगों को वोट दिलवाया और अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह वोट भारी अक्सरियत के साथ आज़ाद कश्मीर के अवाम ने मुस्लिम लीग नून की जमात को हुक्मरानी के लिए और मुंतखब किया ये इलेक्शन 21 जुलाई 2016 को हुए थे उसके बाद 30 जुलाई 2016 को हमारे कायद जनाब वज़ीर आज़म आज़ाद कश्मीर राजा फारूक अदर खान साहब ने अलम उठाया उसके बाद गवर्नमेंट की तश्कील हो गई लेकिन अफसोस न्याय तो सौ साथ अफसोस से ये बात कहना पड़ता है कि जिस अवाम ने बहुत बड़ी विधु के साथ बहुत बड़ी तवक्कुआत के साथ मुस्लिम लीग नून की हुकूमत को मुंतखब किया था मुस्लिम लीग नून की हुकूमत अपने इब्तदाई 3 माह में वो कर जारी शो नहीं कर सकी
Elections in Pakistan administered Kashmir are largely rigged and the entire process is considered as farce. Locals allege that elections in the region have always been fixed in favor of the party which is in power in Islamabad.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan, dozens of Afghans deported from Germany arrived in capital Kabul on Thursday. They are the first group of rejected asylum seekers to return home under an agreement reached between the two countries earlier this year.
A chartered plane carrying 38 Afghans, all men, arrived in the capital city of Afghanistan early on Thursday from Frankfurt. It is Berlin's first group deportation of refugees to the war-torn country following a deal struck with Kabul earlier this year. The Afghan Ministry of Refugees is set to help returnees get back to their home provinces. Some of the deported say they did not even have the time to gather their belongings. The next plane has been chartered for the beginning of January, according to German media reports. More than 1 million migrants from the Middle East, Africa and elsewhere have arrived in Germany since the beginning of 2015. Prompting concerns about security and integration.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal's new government led by Pushpa Kamal Dahal was elected for its promise on addressing the Madhesi issue. But Madhesi leaders complain that their grievances still go unheeded.
The Madhesi parties have strongly condemned the Constitution Amendment Bill registered by the government in the parliament with the support from the main opposition CPN-UML, claiming it to be an attempt to bring catastrophe. The Madhesi-based parties have criticized the government, led by Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal, for maintaining an indifferent attitude towards the plight of the Madhesi community.
ऐसा है कि मदेश आंदोलन के द्वारा उठाया गया जो मांग है मदेशियों का जनजातियों का उस मांग का संबोधन संविधान संशोधन करके करना पड़ेगा अभी जो संशोधन प्रस्ताव आया है उसको परिमार्जन करके उसको संशोधन करना चाहिए उसके बाद ही किसी प्रकार का निर्वाचन हो सकता है अन्यथा किसी प्रकार का निर्वाचन नेपाल में संभव नहीं है और उस निर्वाचन को हम लोग समर्थन नहीं कर सकते
leader of Sanghya Samajwadi Forum Nepal questioned the basis on which the government is planning to hold the elections, reiterating the need to rewrite the amendment bill. Another Madhesi party threatened to boycott the local election if government refuses to meet their demands. Madhesi leaders have claimed that the ruling CPN Maoist Center and the Nepali Congress are using the consensual proposal as an excuse to avoid the issues, including the revision of federal boundaries, one of the key demands of the Madhesi-based parties.
Archery is the traditional game of Ladakh region in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province. An archery tournament for differently abled was recently held in Leh town for motivating them to showcase their skills and promote the sport.
Differently abled archers wowed people with their skills at a tournament held in Leh town of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province. It was aimed at motivating the differently abled and preserving the traditional sport. A total of 96 archers from 24 teams belonging to different parts of Leh participated in the tournament. Women too enthusiastically participated in the tournament.
एक तो वो मैसेज देना है कि differently abled हो के भी लोग बराबर कंधे से कंधा मिला के हर चीज में शामिल कर हो सकता है क्योंकि अभी आज देखा है हम सब ने कि differently abled लोग ने भी काफी इसमें archery में बढ़ चढ़कर हिस्सा लिया बल्कि competition में बहुत पीछे भी नहीं रहा तो इसे मौका दिया जाए तो differently abled लोग भी बहुत आगे निकल सकता है
Ladakh Scouts Red was adjudged the winner. It won the tournament with 268 points. The tournament was organized by a non-profit working for rights of the differently abled.
A cricket tournament for the youth in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province was recently organized by the army. Large crowds gathered to cheer the players and boost their morale.
Large number of people, including students, army personnel and locals, thronged the sports stadium in Rajouri district to support the young cricketers. A cricket tournament for the youngsters of Rajouri and Poonch districts of Jammu and Kashmir province was organized by the Indian Army.
Indian Army ka shukar guzar hoon jo humare beech itna acha tournament leke aaye. Uske baad main यहाँ पे आए हुए तमाम जो लोग थे जो हमें सपोर्ट कर रहे थे या फिर मैच देखने आए थे उनका वेलकम करता हूँ कि वो अपने कीमती वक्त निकालकर यहाँ पे आए।
The players showed immense enthusiasm and hope that more such initiatives were taken to promote sports among the youth in the region.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Four militants loot bank in India's Kashmir, two identified by police. Germany deports Afghan asylum seekers. And Madhesi leaders insist constitution amendment prior polls. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.